السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. Welcome once again to التلقي and تدبر with myself Abdullah Hussein from Masjid Kampong Siglap. الحمد لله. Hope you are having a wonderful morning. Beginning your morning with the recitation of the Quran, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the barakah of the Quran fill your day with barakah. اللهم إنا نسألك خير ما في هذا اليوم. See Allah, O Allah, we ask of you the good of this day. فتحه ونصره, the victory and the help. ونوره وبركته, the light and the barakah, your guiding light to guide us through this day and barakah and fill our day with blessings. ونعوذ بك من شر ما في هذا اليوم. And O Allah, we ask your protection, we seek your protection from all the evil of this day, sharrima ba'dahu, and from any evil which comes after this day. Let us begin today's recitation, today's session with a recitation of Al-Fatiha Ummul Kitab. A'udhu billahi minash shayteen. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. الحمد لله. All praise is due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the Lord of the worlds, and may Allah سبحانه وتعالى send his choicest blessings and salutations upon his beloved and our beloved master Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim tasliman kathiran kathira amin rabbal alamin. Insha'Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, today's recitation, we're reciting page 44 and page 45 of the Quran, beginning our recitation from verse 260 of Suratul Baqarah. So if we need to open our mushafs, let us get our mushafs ready, open to page 44. Or we can follow along the text which will be displayed on the screen, inshallah. So let's begin our recitation. Are you ready, inshallah? Let's begin our recitation. Verse 260.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ بأرني كيف تحيي الموتى قال أولم تؤمن قال أولم تؤمن قال بلى ولكن ليطمئن قلبي قال فخذ أربعة من الطير فصرهن إليك ثم اجعل على كل جبل منهن جزءا ثم اجعل على كل جبل منهن جزءا ثم ادعهن يأتينك سعيا واعلم أن الله عزيز حكيم. مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة مئة حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء والله واسع عليم الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله ثم لا يتبعون ما أنفقوا منا ثم لا يتبعون ما أنفقوا منا ولا أذى لهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون قول معروف ومغفرة خير من صدقة يتبعها أذى والله غني حليم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى كالذي ينفق ماله رئاء الناس ولا يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فمثله كمثل صفوان عليه تراب فأصابه وابل فتركه صلدا لا يقدرون على شيء مما كسبوا والله لا يهدي القوم الكافرين ومثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم ابتغاء مرضات الله وتثبيتا من أنفسهم كمثل جنة بربوة أصابها وابل فآتت أكلها ضعفين فإن لم يصبها وابل فطل والله بما تعملون بصير أيود أحدكم أن تكون له جنة من نخيل وأعناب تجري من تحتها الأنهار له فيها من كل الثمرات وأصابه الكبر وله ذرية ضعفاء فأصابها إعصار فيه نار فاحترقت كذلك يبين الله لكم الآيات لعلكم تتفكرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا من طيبات ما كسبتم ومما أخرجنا لكم من الأرض ولا تيمموا الخبيث منه تنفقون ولستم بآخذيه إلا أن تغمضوا فيه واعلموا أن الله غني حميد الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم يؤتي الحكمة من يشاء ومن يؤت الحكمة فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب صدق الله العظيم
الحمد لله We've just recited two pages from the Quran, page 44 and page 45 of Surah Al-Baqarah. In these pages, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the story of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, where he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show him how he gives life to the dead. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then instructed him to gather four birds, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him how he brings the dead back to life. In verse 261, the second ayah which we recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs us of the virtue of those who spend their wealth in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is sadaqah. It's the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that every limb, every bone of the body has, you have to give a sadaqah for every bone in your body every day when the sun rises. And sadaqah and spending does not necessarily mean to spend your wealth in the path of Allah, but as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains in that hadith, that every good deed is a charity. Even removing an obstacle, removing a harm from another person, This is also counted as sadaqah and charity. So in ayah 261, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the example of those who spend in the path of Allah. And Allah says, مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله. The example of those who spend their wealth in the way of Allah. So in the way of Allah, this means, this can have many meanings. Any good cause, this, all the good causes are counted as the way of Allah. As mentioned in that hadith, that even removing some harm from your brother, removing an obstacle from the road, will be counted as charity. So what is the example? The example is كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ. It is like a seed. One single seed. So say for example, you give one single seed, $1 in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happens to that seed after you plant it, after you spend it in the way of Allah? It is like a seed of grain which grows 7 spikes. So on one stalk, there are 7 spikes. And each spike contains 100 grains. Subhanallah. So in other words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply your reward up to 700 times. From spending one seed, you are getting the reward of 700. And this does not stop there. It does not mean that 700 is the maximum. But Allah says, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. And Allah multiplies the reward for him for whom he wills. And Allah is all-encompassing. وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ. Allah is all-encompassing. عَلِيمٌ. Allah is all-knowing. Allah knows our intentions. And according to our intention and sincerity, our reward will either increase many more times than 700, or we will get no reward if we have no sincerity. So spending in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has many virtues. The greatest of all the virtues is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is a means of cooling the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a hadith says that إِنَّ صَدَقَةَ تُطْفِئُ غَضَبَ الرَّبِّ. That sadaqah, verily, sadaqah and charity, spending in the path of Allah, extinguishes the anger, the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَمَا يُطْفِئُ الْمَاءُ النَّارُ. That's like how water extinguishes a fire. The spending in the path of Allah extinguishes the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is a means of any calamity that was about to befall us, it will be a means of the diversion of that calamity. And as we know, that spending in the path of Allah is an investment for the hereafter. For when we spend in the path of Allah, it does not decrease our wealth, but we are sending it forth to the hereafter, where it actually matters and where it will never come to an end. So let us today try to spend something in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a sincere intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes all difficulty from us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with us. And make the sadaqah as a means of protection between us and the fire of Jahannam, and pave our way to Jannah through this charity in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the ability to practice on what has been said. Insha'Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until we meet again next week for Talaqiyya and Tadabbur. Fi amanillah. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.